story structure and what's practical and what isn't to make a Doctor Who. And I worked with them, which must have seemed a very long period for both of us. Yeah, rewrite after rewrite, you know. And eventually I got what was a more or less workable storyline out of them, and they did The Claws of Aptos, you know, which is a great show, I think. But what I'm really pleased of and proud of that is that since then they went on to do 10 shows altogether. They've done 10 Doctor Who's, which is a real achievement.
Bernard here again. It's just like being in heaven, but without the wings. Back to it.
Next.
Jon was such a big personality. He wasn't just a big man, 6 foot two or three or four, but he was a huge personality, and he was a great friend to all of us. He was a tremendous guide, and the thing that I think I remember most about him, actually, was not just that he's one of the funniest men I've ever met, but also he really wanted to know deeply about all the people that he was working with. He took care of us. He was a sort of father figure. He was very cool.
Very cool. Well, like everybody, I mean, he was my friend. He was my mentor. I mean, I was very young, and it was only my second job in the business as an actress. And I'd grown up listening to Jon, and he encouraged me with my voices. He said that he was the one that made me go on stage, because I thought I was going to do television for the rest of my life. And he said, no, you'll have to go on stage, and you'll have to do comedy, because you've got a funny face. But he was wonderful. He was a great raconteur. He was, as you say, he was so caring about everybody. And we basically, for the whole time, we spent all our time together, we ate together, and it's lovely to be able to work with somebody, to learn from somebody. And he was very nurturing and caring, and indeed one of the funniest people in the world. And he was very good at telling stories. And you know, he was a joy to be around, and we are very, very lucky, whether it had been in Doctor Who or whatever, if he'd come into our lives, it would have been the same blessing. Absolutely.
Bernard, what was it like for you as a guest artist coming into Doctor Who? This family, this...
That was awful. It was four episodes. The first of all, it was going to be six, and then it was reduced to four. Working with him there on that, he was just a true pro. He was an actor who knew his lines, an actor who could work with anybody, and on occasion, be very funny.
Very fine. Because neither of them ever actually wanted to kill the other, and there are various times that you see that that was the case. And Jo felt the same way, oddly enough. She got strangely fond of this man, because before he went to the dark side, he was actually...
Stephen Thorne.
No.
Omega.
Anyway, before he went to the dark side, so he was a good man, and I think that, and it was lovely to have that game of chess that they used to play together. It was an incredible start when baronets came in. I think, yeah. Not just for boys.
And Richard, did you have any kind of? I was watching the action scene, the episode four where you and Jon are in the back of the jeep being attacked by orange things. And notice it
won't be
working. You actually had your gun upside down, but I'm going to brush over that. Yes. Did you have any kind of training or kind of guidance from any military, just to kind of so you knew exactly how a captain would act, how a sergeant would behave?
Well, actually, I didn't need any training, because I was a captain, and I had been in the army, and I knew how a sergeant ought to behave. When I took his sandwich, that was perfectly in order. Brad has his privileges, you know. Yeah.
So were you able...
Sandwiches came into Doctor Who in our day, didn't
they?
Yes.
There was a moment also making hot chocolate, as you remember, which is not reported, in which the Doctor in the very early days caught me making a cup of hot chocolate on his Bunsen burner. But just to go back to that conflict between John P. and the Master. I mean, this is the basis of drama. You've got to have conflict, and then the resolution of the conflict. And so, obviously, if one of them were to die, you'd have no conflict left. You'd have no battle. And it's very much, it's the Sherlock Holmes and Moriarty thing, isn't it, really?
But then it also has the kickback that after a period of time, you can't have the same thing happening. So sadly, for quite a few episodes, we didn't have Roger in it, you know, because it was becoming...
He was becoming overused.
Overused, and you wanted to always surprise everybody when you brought him.
Mm. And for a long time, you and Joe and the Doctor were based on Earth. You were, you know, very kind of home.
It was actually only for the first few seasons. I mean, after that, once we'd gone, we were most of them apart from the Green Death.
Yes. And then your first one, I think, was obviously you had an excursion with the three Doctors going through the black hole and meeting Omega.
Stephen Thorpe. I met him a lot. Sacrificed me.
Brute. Then you had like Curse of Peladon, when you first kind of went out and stood up for a while.
That Joe was going to have a dalliance on virtually
every
planet.
Yes.
but yeah, no, it was very interesting and very, I thought, quite right to set it on Earth, because what's more frightening to you if suddenly at the back of this theatre on this planet, some Autons came marching down here, you know, or whatever it was. It's much more frightening to think of it happening here, whereas if you go wherever up there is, you don't expect to see anything that looks or resembles us, because of the difference in the air and all the rest of it. So I think it's much more frightening to me to think of something actually happening on this planet.
Yeah, if you've gone through that little door with the green light on it, and you'd opened the toilet door, and there was an Auton sitting on the...
Exactly,
he
ripped his face off.
Ah! Ah!
Don't you know what I mean?
Yes.
That was scary. I mean, they had policemen sitting in the car, and they ripped the blooming face off, and kids were going out into the street, and the policemen were going, ah!
So they got into a lot of trouble for that, didn't they? Yeah.
Questions in Parliament for that.